In this video, we're going to take a look at reader mode in Safari on the Mac. With reader mode, what we're able to do is strip out all of what I call all of the noise when we're reading an article. All of those ads that we see, we can strip all of that out and just read the article. We can even have Safari do this for us automatically when we visit a specific website. Let's take a look at reader mode or reader view in Safari on the Mac. Let's go to my Mac. So I'm in macOS Ventura on my Mac here, and I'm using Safari. Now, this has been around, reader mode or reader view has been around for several years, so you don't necessarily need to be using macOS Ventura. It does work on older versions of macOS as well. So what is reader mode or reader view? Well, let's go over to an article. I'm going to go to this article here. I'm over at yahoo.com. When we're looking at an article, let's go ahead and click on it. You're going to see that there are a lot of ads within this article. I have ads at the top. I have ads on the right. And in some cases, we may even have ads within the article. Let's go ahead and click on Story Continues. So what I would like to do is strip out all of what I call noise, all of this noise. Well, that's basically what reader mode or reader view does. All we have to do to take all of that extra noise out and just focus on the article is go up to the top where our address bar is, and you're going to see this little article icon to the left of the address bar. When I click on this, what it's going to do is strip all of that out, and I'm just left with my article here. So I can easily read this without all of the other distractions. To go back to the regular mode, all we do is just click on this article here again, and it brings us back. Now, this little article view is not going to show on every page. If we go back over to our Yahoo directory, you're going to see that that does not show there. I can't put this page into reader mode. It's not available on all pages. Basically, it's available on any page that has an article, although there's a catch. Some developers or some web developers could disable this. So it's not even going to be available on all articles. But for the most part, you can count on it being there when you click on an article. Now, when we click on an article, let's go back to our Iron Man article here. When we click on an article, what it's going to do is show you all of the text when you first initially get there. If you recall, when I went over to this page, there was Story Continues. If I do not click on this little Story Continues icon, watch what happens. I'm going to go to my reader view. What's going to happen is it's going to show me only what is shown on that page. This article is a lot longer. So what we need to do is make sure that if you're at a website that does not show the entire article, what you need to do is make sure that you go to Story Continues. When I click on this, now what it'll do is it'll show me all of the article when I click on this. So let's go ahead and click on it. And we can see there's a lot more to this article. Now, luckily, most websites do not have that Story Continues. Yahoo is a big user of it. It all depends on the website that you go to. But for the most part, if you go to CNN or anything like that, you will not have that. So that's basically how we use our reader mode. Let's go ahead and open up another article. We're going to go to this article here. I click on it. I'm going to see if there's a Story Continues. There is, so I just click on it. Now it's showing me the whole article. And now what I can do is go up to reader mode and read the entire article. If we go to CNN, where we do not have that Story Continues, let's go ahead and click on an article here. We're going to go to entertainment, and we're going to go to this one here. And we do not have Story Continues here. We can see that that article is hard to read because the ads take up a lot of that page. So what I do is I go up to the article button here, or the reader view button here, click on it, and now I can read that article. Now, I mentioned in the introduction, we can set this on a per-site basis. In other words, we can have it go into reader mode automatically when we go to a specific website. So let's say with CNN, I would always like it to go into reader mode. Any article that I read on CNN is going to go into reader mode automatically. How can I do that? Well, all we need to do is just go back up to our icon here. And if we click and hold, you're going to see Use Reader Automatically on CNN. So all I need to do is just select this. And now whenever I go to an article in CNN, let's go ahead and find another article. We're going to go with this one here. And we can see that it went into reader mode automatically. We can do the same thing with Yahoo. Let's go over to Yahoo here. And we click and hold up here. And I'm going to say Use Reader Automatically on Yahoo. Select it. And now any article that I go to on Yahoo, let's go ahead and go to my directory again. It's going to go into reader mode automatically. Now, in some cases, you're going to see that it didn't do it. So I'm going to refresh. When I refresh, it goes into reader mode. So it's not always perfect, but it does work really pretty good. And all you have to do if it doesn't go into reader mode is just click on it here. Or if you have it set for automatically going into reader mode, just refresh the page. If you no longer want it to do that, as in Yahoo here, what it does is it only shows part of the article because they have story continue. So I don't want it to do that with Yahoo yet. What I can do is I can click and hold this, and then all I have to do is just uncheck this. And when I do, it is no longer going to go into reader mode automatically. I can always do it manually, but it is not going to do this automatically. Now, let's say you set up a lot of websites for reader mode. And what you would like to do is see all of those websites that you have reader mode set for. Maybe you want to turn a couple of them off. How can you do that? How can you get a list of all of the websites that you use in reader mode on? Well, what we need to do is go to our Safari settings. Now, if you're using an older version of macOS, this would be Safari preferences. But either way, what we do is we go up to Safari here, and then we go over to our settings or preferences. I'll show you a shortcut to this towards the end of the video. So I'm going to click on this. And now what we need to do is go over to websites. And under websites, we need to make sure that we're looking at reader. When we're looking at reader here, you're going to see all of the websites that you use in reader mode on. And you can see what the status is. So I go over here and I can see the status. So from here, I'm able to turn Yahoo on and off. I'm able to turn CNN on and off. And if I want to remove it altogether, I can do that as well. You click on it, and then you're going to see remove, and you're able to remove that website altogether. We can also set what the behavior is when we go to a website. Maybe we want to use reader mode automatically on all sites, and then I can turn them off for specific sites. To do that, what we would do is we'd go over to the bottom here. You can see when visiting other websites. I select it, turn it on. And now whenever I visit any website that has an article, it's going to go into reader mode automatically, except for Yahoo, because I have that turned off. Now I mentioned that there's an easier way to get to all of that. Well, when you have this little article up here, when you click and hold on it, you know how this is how we turn it on for a specific website. Well, if I click and hold on it, you're going to see Reader Website Settings. This will take you to Safari Settings or Preferences and go to that spot where we have our reader mode automatically. So all I have to do is just select this, and we can see it opened up to my websites and the reader. Let's go ahead and go to General here. And I'm going to go back over to my Safari Settings here, or my Reader Settings. Click and hold. Go to Reader Website Settings, select it, and you can see it brought me over to Websites and Reader automatically. And then from here, what I'm able to do is make any changes. I'm going to turn this back off for all websites, and I'm going to leave it on for specific websites. So that is our reader mode or reader view in Safari. As you can see, it can greatly enhance how we read articles. It can basically strip out all of the noise, all of the ads out of an article. Now, again, this doesn't work on all websites. And in some websites, it may not be the best way of doing it, especially if you use automatic, such as Yahoo, because they use a lot of that story continue. So you have to click on that first and then go into reader mode. The nice thing is you can turn this on and off for each specific website just by going to Safari's settings or preferences. So that is reader mode or reader view in Safari on the Mac.